Now we don't press the bar up, but we push ourselves underneath the bar. How many weights you can do? This one would be the lowest one. In general, we have these four shoulder to overhead or S2O exercises. And these vary from the strict press to the push press. To the push jerk, to the split jerk. So I'm going to draw a line right here in the middle. Okay, so again, we have the strict press, the push jerk, and the split jerk. Immediately, what you need to look for is over here. This and this. So these four, we can split them in two groups. One group for the jerks and one group for the presses. So when we start over here, you see what a strict press is. It's basically a lot of strength requirements in the shoulder, so in the upper body, and not a lot of complexity in this movement. So as to how many weights you can do, this one would be the lowest one. And as the requirements of strength in the upper body, it would be the highest one. So lowest weight, highest requirements of strength. So again, this movement is pretty simple. We have the bar on the shoulders, we press up. We don't use a dip, we don't use the lower body, we just simply press the bar from the shoulders to overhead. Don't underestimate this movement though, it can be really difficult. But in terms of these four shoulder to overhead movements, the strict press is the easiest one. So, non-complex. Then when we go over into the push press, we are able to grab a little bit more weight. So, more weight. Then the strict press, strict. And the reason being that we are now able to use the legs to push the bar off of the shoulders and then finish up the movement using the strength in the shoulders. So we use the legs during the initiation of the movement, but we still finish up the movement using the shoulders. And that is basically the difference between the push press and the push jerk. Whereas with a push press, we press the bar up, that we initiate the movement with a leg drive. But with a push jerk, we make a dip, we drive up, we get the bar off of the shoulders, and now we don't press the bar up, but we push ourselves underneath the bar. And as you can tell, this sounds a little bit more difficult than the push press. So for that reason, this one is more complex then, because now we have to think around, okay, I have the bar on the shoulders, I extend my hips, I get the bar up, I need to push myself underneath, I need to still maintain that good position in my lower body so that my knees are in line with my toes, my hips go back, my knees go forward, I'm in this good position with my torso. So all these things we need to think about during the push jerk, and this is more difficult than the push press. So because we're able to use more legs in this movement, we are able to get more weight on the bar during the push jerk than during the push press. So more weight than the push press. And as you might have guessed, during the push jerk, there's less requirements of force of the shoulder muscle. So there's less range of motion and we press the bar up because we push ourselves underneath the barbell. So there's less requirements of force basically for the shoulders and more requirements for speed to get ourselves underneath the bar. So then when we move over from the push jerk to the split jerk, again, we go underneath the bar. And that's what the jerk describes us. The jerk describes that you get yourself underneath the bar after you've finished the triple extension. So after you finished the extending phase, you get underneath the bar. And that's the main difference between the jerk and the push press. Because of course with a strict press there's no leg movement at all, but the push press there is a little leg movement, and they could get mixed up a little bit. So then when we go over from the push jerk to the split jerk, this one is the most complex of these four shoulder to overhead movement. So we're going to write it down here, most complex. But with that complexity, there comes more weight. So if you've mastered the split jerk, you should be able to get more weight on the bar than with a push jerk. And when you've mastered the push jerk, you should be able to get more weight on the bar than the push press. And when you've mastered the push press, you should be able to get more weight on the bar as with a strict press. So the split jerk enables us to move the highest amounts of weight of these four, but it's also the slowest one. Because when we do a split jerk, we constantly need to adjust our feet position back to the center line, get the bar back, split jerk, get the feet back, get the bar back. It's way slower than, for instance, a push jerk when we get underneath the bar, just extend the knees and get the bar back down. So I'm gonna draw another line over here, and over here, and over here, and over here. So when a workout would say S2O, or shoulder to overhead, and you're able to choose between these four, or even other shoulder to overhead variations, and then the strict press would not be the smartest option to choose from, being that the strict press is the slowest, and does not enable you to make a lot of reps, because you will fatigue way quicker in these shoulders than with the other shoulder to overhead variations. So as to speed, this is slow, the strict press. This is a great exercise to get stronger in the upper body and to progress into, let's say, a handstand push-up, or to strengthen these three exercises. But in regards to a what or a workout, this is not a smart option. And when we go diagonally down to the split jerk, this would most likely not be a smart option either, if the weight is moderate. So if we have a moderate weight that we are able to do the push jerk and the push press with, and the split jerk is not that necessary, that it is not that high of a weight for an individual, this option is also pretty slow. And that is not the split jerk itself, but setting back up to neutral and making the rep is way slower than with a push jerk and a push press. When we do a split jerk and we want to get the rep, we need to get the feet back to that neutral line, then get the bar back, which takes longer than with the push jerk and the push press, where we can just extend the knees out and we have the rep. So this one is the slowest. This one is also the slowest. I'm not sure which one is slower, because if we have a lot of weight, strict press could get real slow. So then when we have the push jerk and the push press, I would think that the push press is faster, because when you have the elbows extended, your rep is done and you can go back down. In regards to the push jerk, when we have the elbows extended, we need to extend the knees before we are able to get the bar back down, or else it's not a rep. So I would suggest that the push press is quicker than the push jerk. But then if we have a light weight and we know that we're not going to fatigue in the shoulders, the push press is a good option. But if the weights increase a little bit and we're not able to maintain the form, and we're having slow push presses when we go up, we're not able to finish up the rep, then the push jerk would be a smarter option. And again, this is also pretty quick. So you would use a push jerk for a weight that you're not 100% sure that you're able to maintain with the push press. So yeah, those are the four most common options for the shoulder to overhead. We have the strict press, the push jerk, and the split jerk. You could also get the thruster in, or a squat jerk, just exercises that move the bar from the shoulders to over your head. How you do it depends on you. But again, depending on the workout, the stimulus of the workout, and the individual, these four options are most common. So with a front squat, we have the elbows in a 90 degree angle, and we have the bar in the fingertips. And with the shoulder to overhead, we are not able to do this, because if we have the bar at the fingertips, it creates a lot more force on the wrists, which will increase the potential risk of injuries. And that's the reason that you oftentimes hear individuals say that their wrists are a little bit hurt because of all the front squat and the shoulder to overhead exercises that they push into the wrists while they are getting the bar upwards. So we don't want the bar at the fingertips during the shoulder to overhead, and we don't want the elbows high because we want to press using the shoulder muscles. And if you get the elbows high, we would initiate the movement by extending the elbows out using the tricep muscles, which are a lot smaller than the shoulder muscles. So during the shoulder to overhead front rack, we want a angle of approximately 45 degrees. So that would be around this angle. So guys, for next week's breakdown video, we're going to zoom in on the push jerk and the push press, because I noticed that a lot of individuals mix these two up, and they do the push press when the workout clearly says that you need to do a push jerk. So we're going to zoom in on these two and how to switch from both and just spend some time with those two exercises. So guys, I see you next week. Don't forget to subscribe, and see you later. Ciao.